guys, we are going to do you a quick video on how Chris does the process of his hook making. And yes, we're out here in the barn, so it's a little chilly, but he is going to give you a quick rundown on how he does the hooks. So we have an order for one for Miss Joan, and it is a Coco Bolo, so he is going to give you a example of how he does the exotic wood hooks. So those of you who don't follow me on my Facebook and don't know about the exotic wood hooks that we do for crochet hooks, you'll get to see this firsthand. So we're going to do them in clips, and I'm going to put it together in a video for you, and you will see certain parts of it. Certain parts are going to be too loud where he does it with the saw. So we're going to put this together, and we'll be back in a few minutes and show you what it's all about. Alright guys, here's a quick view. This is how we get the blocks of wood when they come in for the most part. This is a standard size that we order. Some come in this size, then others come in this size. We also have some that come in this size, but not very many. Depends on what it is. So the sizes do vary, and if I turn the camera a little sideways, you can see he has a table that does consist of a couple different sizes of woods. So the one that he's holding right now is the Coco Bolo. So this is a smaller block that we do get, that we usually only get about 4 hooks out of, depending on the size that we get an order for. So Miss Joan's hook is going to come out of this one, and he is going to go ahead and cut her hook, the blank out of this one, on the saw table. But we're not going to film that because it's very loud, so we'll be right back once he has that cut. Okay, so he has cut the blank out, so now this is what you're going to see after he has the size of the wood. So the rest of the part that he's going to do now is he's going to start shaving this down a bit.
I'm going to take my block plane here and just knock the corners off, so that way when I spin it, it's going to be a little less work. See, and that starts to make it round. See, and it starts taking the corners off, and it turns it from a square to it starts to make it a little rounder. I'm going to go ahead and finish this up and then get it ready for the next step, and we'll see you back.
We'll be right back with you in a second.
All right, we're back. I got it kind of sort of round. What I'm going to do now is I put it in my drill, and I'm going to use that to spin it so I can take this sandpaper and start to make it round and get it to size. It's a little loud, but it's not too bad. Now just start working this thing and keep working it back and forth, trying to keep it even and round. This part takes quite a while, especially on some of the smaller hooks, because the smaller the hook, the more I have to turn it down smaller. There you can see it's not square anymore. See how it's kind of square up here? And down here where I've been working it, it's getting rounder. Got a little ways to go on this. I'll finish rounding this thing out, and then we'll come back for the next step. Alright, here we are. I got one end turned down and turned down the size. You can see where it started out. This is the end we started out with. And now it's nice and round. I got my handy dandy old checker here, and it's nice number 8 size hook. That's what we're making, a 5mm. So that one's about 2/3 of the way done. I got this end here to turn around and get to size, and then we'll come back and start to make it look like a hook. All right, here we are. Got it all the way around. As you can see, it's a number, letter H, 5mm all the way across. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and start putting a hook on the end. I'm going to put on this end here. Take my little teeny tiny saw. It's got real small teeth on it. Just kind of eyeball this thing. I want to make it right about there. I'll put my angle cut first. About halfway through. And then what I do is I take my razor knife. Start to cut this out a little bit at a time. Chips. And there we can see this, the starting point of my hook end. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start to shave this down, and then we're going to go in the house where I can go ahead and finish it. I don't need to do any more out here. The rest of the handwork I can do sitting in the house where it's a little warmer. I'll see you in a little bit. All right, here we are back in the where it's a little bit warmer, and we're going to start. First thing I need to do is start shaping the groove for the yarn. I gotta do that with some sandpaper. And I apologize, my hands and my nails are not as nice as Stitchinstacy's. But what we'll do is you just start sanding this thing. And this is the most important step to making a nice hook that glides real easy, is getting this angle and getting this extremely smooth in here. Way the yarn will glide. Some of the ladies that have my hooks say they glide like Cadillacs, and they're really, really smooth. That's because I take extra time in shaping the end. That I'm machine made and a factory made hook, they just don't take the time to make them like this. It takes a while. Alright, that looks pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and shape the outside of the end some. So when you put it through your loops, it'll slide through there really nice. Get this shape right. It's taking me quite a while to get the shape down on how I want these things to look. They're not exactly like any of the bot hooks. They're kind of a cross between the two major brands. They're a little deeper than the one and got more of a different shape than the other. If you notice, when I'm going down this thing, I'm always going try to go along the hook. Two reasons for that. One reason is that's the way the grain in the wood runs, and you want to go along your grain. It makes it smoother. And the other reason is that's the direction that y'all are using these hooks. So I want to sand them in the direction that you're going to use. It makes them run smoother. I'm gonna start off with this as a rougher sandpaper. It's not real rough, but do these same steps about three times with three different sandpapers, going from a coarser grit to a finer grit. Well, the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit of a bevel right here on the edge with my just got a little small file. And that, what that does is it puts that little feature on the outside here. Catch to give the yarn somewhere to go when it's hooking on the yarn. Or I don't know if you can see that really good. I put that little groove in, see the sides where it just starts as flat. And then I'll put that little yarn catcher groove in there. I'll do that on both sides. And I got that little nice little groove cut in each side. The next thing I need to do is get my other sandpaper here. I got several different ones shaped different. And get that so I can get that, smooth that groove out a little bit. Pretty good right there. Get this other piece.
George making his appearance back here.
Alright, now what I need to do is this edge right here is real, real sharp where I cut that in. I need to go ahead and blend that edge in so it doesn't hook on the catch on the yarn. Feels pretty good. Some of this stuff I do by feel. I still have to wear my glasses. I got these big magnifiers, the real fancy ones. Got them at the dollar store.
He has nice polka dot glasses.
But that's pretty good there. Just knock these edges down here. I'll come around to this end and I just bevel this off a little bit, make it nicer here on the end so it looks a little nicer. Alright, now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go to my next sandpapers and I'll sand this thing and probably take me another 10 or 15 minutes of sanding and get it nice and smooth here, and then we'll come back and see what it looks like then. Alright, we're back now after 20 or 25 minutes of sanding on this. Went through four different grits of sandpaper. This is what we got. nice and smooth. Everything's all blended nice. It's just about done now. What I'm going to do now is I have a wood burner. I've been marking the sides of these. It looks really good on the lighter colored woods. On the darker colored woods, it looks good, but it's a little harder to see. I'll hold it down there. And this is going to be an H, so we'll go ahead and scorch this in there. There we have the H. It's really hard to see. It's more indented into the wood than it is actually coloring it because the wood is so dark. The burnt doesn't show up as well as it does on the lighter colored woods. Now we'll go in the other room and we're going to go ahead and put a finish on this and then let Stacy go ahead and take it for a test drive. She checks every hook that I make to make sure that there's no little catches or something that I'm not seeing. She makes sure that they're good and smooth for everybody. And we'll go in the other room and put a finish on it. All right, here we are back. The hook is done. It's marked. I'm going to go ahead and finish it. And I finish all my hooks with Formby's tongue oil. It's just an oil-based finish that kind of seals the wood. Brings out the grain a little bit, makes them look a little prettier. Kind of a hand-rubbed oil finish. And I'll just dunk it in there and put it in the rag. And just really, and I'm really bearing down hard squeezing this and pulling it back and forth, and it's kind of, what that does is it rubs that oil right down into the wood and also helps polish it just a little bit. Go ahead and get some on this other end. That part. Now to get up into the hook part, you're gonna like this, and this is always it.
Him his little techniques.
That gets a nice throat down in there. Kind of a three-handed job. I only have two, so gonna hold the rest of it with my mouth just to last final shine on this dry cloth. And I would say that Joan, your 5mm Cocobolo hardwood handmade crochet hook is ready for Stacy to go ahead and give it a test drive, and let's see how this thing works. But came out really nice. It's got pretty good grain in it. This Cocobolo is kind of a reddish brown and black kind of streak together. Sometimes they got a little more reddish brown, sometimes they got a little more black. This one here is a little blacker on one side and it's a little more reddish on this other side, but up in here it's pretty nice and pretty. I kind of got it where it, the part that of the hook that you're looking at all the time, I try to make the best finish on that. But let's go ahead and give this to Stacy and see what she thinks.
Hey guys, okay, it's my turn. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna test Miss Jones' hook. I'm gonna make sure that it has no flaws with it. Make sure it does not catch the yarn. As you know, I'm a speedy crocheter, so if it does catch the yarn in any way, I will detect it. Okay, so let's go ahead and make our slip knot. And I'm using some of this really nice pink flamingo yarn. And what we're just going to do is make a simple chain. And then I'll start off slow. And it's really nice, and I'll test it to make sure that all the way through too that it doesn't catch along the shaft anywhere, and it doesn't. Making sure the neck here doesn't catch, and it doesn't, and then I just kind of take off and make sure that it goes at my speed. If it goes at my speed, I know it passes the test for pretty much everybody. So if I can go at my speed, it'll go at anybody that is a beginner, intermediate, or professional crocheter. So there is absolutely no problem with this hook. So Miss Joan, I think you'll be very happy with your hook, and you can see it's perfect. All right, guys, that's it for the example of how Chris makes the exotic wood hooks. So I hope you guys enjoyed this experimental video, I guess you would say, on how he does these. So I will see you on the next video. So hope you guys have a great day and happy hooking.